Unit 5, Communication Interfaces of MSP 430. First, communication. Communication means transferring the data from one device to another device. Example, input devices to microprocessors or controllers, or microcontroller to memory, or microcontroller to output devices, or additional hardware circuits. In this diagram, the data is transmitting from MSP 430 to computer using Wi-Fi. So there are two types of communications. One is parallel communication, another one is serial communication. First, parallel communication. In parallel communication, the data is transmitting from transmitter to receiver multiple bits at a time. That means 8 bits at a time. The advantages of parallel communication is, since multiple bits are transmitting at a time, the data transmission time will be less, automatically speed of the transmission increases. So speed of the device will be increases. The disadvantage is, here parallel communication uses multiple wires for transmitting the data, so the cost of the parallel communication is more. So to reduce the cost, they are preferring serial communication. In serial communication, the data is transmitting from transmitter to receiver bit by bit. That means one bit at a time. So for long distance communication, it is preferred because it uses only single wire. The disadvantage is low speed when comparing with parallel communication. So there are three methods in the serial communication. First, simplex. Simplex means in one direction only the data is transmitted, means transmitter to receiver or sensor to microcontroller or microcontroller to LED device, like that. Second, half duplex. Here the data is transmitting from transmitter to receiver in both directions, but one direction only transmitted at a time. Example, walkie talkie. Next, full duplex. In this mode, the data is transmitting from transmitter to receiver and receiver to transmitter at a time. In both directions, the data will be transmitted. Example, mobile phone. Okay, next. Synchronous communication and asynchronous communication. First, synchronous communication. In synchronous communication, first set the same clock frequency for transmitter and receiver, and then bulk data will be transmitted. So it is very high speed since we are transmitting bulk data. In case of asynchronous communication, instead of having the transmitter and receiver having the same clock frequency, both should have identical settings. That means same baud rate, same number of stop bits, and parity bit value should be same for transmitter and receiver. So example for synchronous communication is I2C and SPA, whereas example for asynchronous communication is UART.